The next concept is blood flow and heart attack. This venturimeter is connected to the different arteries which are connected to the heart. Whenever these arteries are closed due to the cholesterol or plaque on the walls, then we should exert more pressure to pump the blood through the nerves and arteries which are connected to the heart. So this difference in the velocities of the blood at each and every point of the nerves and arteries will gives the result of the examination of heart attack. So in venturimeter, on one end we have seen is some constricted thin gaps or thin layers which are able to pass some fluid through it like this. Such like this, this venturimeter, once it is connected to the heart nerves, once if suppose these are the nerves which are connected to the heart, once these are restricted are closed with the plaque on the walls, then the blood will come like this, and here there is a sudden drop of the velocity of the blood because area of cross section is very less. So if area of cross section is very less, then to maintain the constant velocity for the blood force, we should exert more pressure continuously from one end. This more pressure may cause to the heart attack. So this is the functioning of the heart with respect to that. So it causes to the heart attack with due to the pressure. Pressure is equal to force by area. When area is less, more pressure should be applied. That's why doctors used to give advice to take care about the heart, to check the BP levels every day and at least for 1 month. And we should not take the food materials which are highly cholesterol content, because the gaps between the nerves will be closed because of these cholesterols. So which can give the heart attack, means heart doesn't get the sufficient blood at the rate of the common rate. So how it is calculated with the help of venturimeter? For that purpose, we should observe one numerical. This is the problem which is related to the venturimeter and the blood flow. So the flow of blood in a large artery of an anesthetized dog is diverted through a venturimeter. The wider part of the meter has a cross-sectional area equal to that of the artery, nothing but A is equal to 8 millimeter square. The narrower part has an area A is equal to 4 millimeter square. The pressure drop in the artery is 24 pascals. So what is the speed of the blood in the artery? So therefore, capital A, the one end of the area, is equal to 8 millimeter square. Small a is equal to 4 millimeter square. Pressure drop P is equal to 24 pascals. Now we should find out the velocity. So we know that velocity is equal to square root of 2 rho L gh by rho into a by a whole square minus 1, where rho is equal to rho of the blood, 1.06 in 10 to the power of 3 kg per meter cube. Therefore V is equal to, so what is the height and g? So it is no need to calculate this one. This rho gh is nothing but the pressure, so it will be 2 P by rho, square root of 2P by rho into A by A whole square minus 1. Now I am substituting all these values which was given in the problem. Therefore V is equal to square root of 2 into, so what is the pressure? 24 pascals. What is rho? 1.06. into the power of 3 kg per meter cube. A by A, where A is equal to 8, small a is equal to 4, 8 by 4 whole square minus 1. therefore it is square root of 48 by 1.06 into 10 cube into 2 square minus 1. 2 square is 4, 4 minus 1 is 3, 3 into 48, 144. By 1.06 into 10 to the power of 3. So now this is 12 by square root of 1.06 into 10 cube. This is 0.106 into 10 to the power of 4. That is nothing but 10 square under the root. So if we calculate the whole thing, we will get 0.125 meters per second. So this is the velocity of the blood which is flowing through the anesthetized artery of the dog.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.